Hello everyone and welcome back to MATLAB tutorial videos. In this video tutorial, I'm going to talk about how you can use vectorized operations instead of using for loops or any kind of loops in MATLAB, which make your code lengthier and bulkier. So let's get started. What is vectorization? It is a process of revising a loop-based or a scalar-oriented code to a MATLAB or a matrix vector operation. I'm going to show you how you can do that. Let's consider an example. Let's say we want to multiply two matrices in an elemental-wise fashion, which means that the first element in the first matrix should be multiplied with the first element in the second matrix, and the second element in the first matrix should be multiplied with the second element in the second matrix, and so on. So for that, let's create two matrices which will have a huge size, so that I can tell you what exactly is the difference between performing loop operations and performing vector operations. So let's get started. First, I'm going to clear and close all the files. I'm going to initialize A. This is going to be the first matrix, and I'm going to use rand I function, which will generate random integers ranging from 0 to 10, and the matrix will have a size of, let's say, 10,000. So that is the first matrix. Similarly, we'll make a second matrix using the same dimension. Now remember, these two matrices won't be the same because every time we use a random function generator function in MATLAB, it generates different random numbers. So even though the format you see for both the matrices is the same, these two matrices are different. As I want to show you how fast the vector operations work in comparison with the loops, I'm going to set a timer in the code, which will be represented by tick and tock. This in the output will show us how much time it took for implementing that loop or that operation. Since we'll be multiplying every element in the matrix, the first matrix, with the second matrix, we will be using a for loop, which will run 10,000 times, and it will perform this operation. I'll end it and let's try running the code and see how much time it takes. So this is the time taken for implementing the loop, which ran 10,000 times. So instead of, now this is one way of doing it, and instead of using this, let's try using vector operations in the same code and we'll find out the time. So while using vector operations, all we have to do is we have to use a basic mathematical operation that can be used in MATLAB with a dot symbol, which will do the work for us, or implement the operation in an elemental fashion, and it reduces the code. Along with that, it reduces the time. So let's simulate it and see how much time it takes. Now you can see it took just half the time to implement the same thing as we did while using the for loop. So this is how you can vectorize any operation. Now this can not only be done with just multiplication, you can use any mathematical operation in the vectorized form. But this will conclude my video. If you've enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button or subscribe to our channel if you want to keep yourself updated with it. If you have any queries, post it in the comment sections and we will try to answer them. Also, if you have any suggestions for different topics you want us to make tutorial videos on, leave it in the comment sections and we will try to make a video on it. I'm going to sign off. Bye bye. Thank you for watching.